Hello, welcome to this video. Let's discover PreSonus Studio 1.6, one of the best DAWs you can use to make your own songs and compositions. This is available for both Windows and Mac OS, with either a monthly subscription called Sphere, or a perpetual license as Professional or Artist. When opening Studio One, its start page shows up divided in three sections. On the left, you get your most recent projects made. On the center, your connected accounts such as SoundCloud. And on the right, the news feed with news and tips from PreSonus. To start with a new project, go to New above and select the right template. With Record and Mix, you make a new independent song, combining audio samples and compositions together. With Master and Release, you make a new project, such as a collection of songs to generate playlists, CDs, and entire albums. Whereas select Rehearse and Perform to create a show, which is a ready workspace for live public shows. To see how Studio One works, let's build a new song. On the right, define the song name, where to save it, and also its sample rate, bit depth resolution, the time base between bars or seconds, and the maximum song length. You can also drag and drop sample files right away, importing .mp3, .wav, .flac files, and much more. When you click on OK, the main workspace opens with the main timeline, the main tools on top, and three main panels you can open with the buttons in the bottom right corner, such as the Browse panel, where to find files, instruments, and effects. You can come back to the Start page by clicking on the second button in the top right corner. Whereas click on Documents to shuffle between your projects in progress. The timeline is the place where you work with your files and compositions within rows, called tracks. Audio tracks collect audio samples, such as rendered files with proper waveform and time. Whereas instrument tracks collect MIDI compositions, which are sequences of notes realizing melodies, drums, and percussions that get sound from virtual synthesizers or external instruments. At first, the timeline shows the audio samples imported from the Start page, but you can drop more files from any folder or the Files section of the Browse panel. These files are shown as colored blocks called events, complete with file name and audio waveform. You can zoom in and out vertically with your mouse wheel while holding down the Control or Command key, and horizontally with Control plus Shift or Command plus Shift. To play back the timeline content, click anywhere to fix the playhead and use the spacebar key, or the player at the bottom to play and stop. The time placement is shown in bars and in seconds, but you can freely change it. So the timeline by going to Time Base above. Now let's see how to record with your microphone. Right-click on the left side to create a new audio track. From the Input Sources list, check if your microphone is present, and select between a stereo L plus R source or a monochannel source. If you do not see your microphone, go to Audio I/O Setup. If your microphone is connected and turned on, it must appear in this list. You can add a new input source with Add and associate the microphone to it. You shall see the microphone responsive to the volume meter of the associated channel. Once you have selected the correct input source, arm the interested track. You shall see the volume meter reactive. Then start recording with the Record button at the bottom. This records over the armed track while you play back the other tracks, without recording them as well. Let's see how to edit these events with the arrow tool enabled. Select any event by clicking on its bottom side and drag it to move it in time or in another track. You can also drag the central node to adjust volume uniformly, holding down the Shift key to sweep smoothly. This is very useful in case the volume meter at the bottom shows red levels of distortion. drag the corner nodes to add fade transitions, and increase or decrease volume smoothly. Set the transition length and adjust its envelope with the central node. Right-click on any event to duplicate, reverse audio, or adjust values such as transpose to change pitch by adding or removing semitones. You can also cut, copy, paste, or remove any event. This acts on the entire event unless you select part of it by clicking and dragging over it. To undo, use Ctrl or Command and Z, or open the History window from the Edit tab. To split any event, click on any point, and use Alt or Option key plus X. Whereas to trim events, just drag their edges. Hold down the Alt or the Option key to stretch and shorten by changing the speed rate, playing the clip slower or faster. On the left side, you get several options to manage each track. Use the M and the S buttons to mute or solo the current track. And drag the horizontal bar to adjust the track volume. Right-click on the track to remove or duplicate it. From the bottom left corner, you can also apply automations, such as track properties like volume and stereo panning that you can change in time. With the arrow tool, drop points and shape the envelope. Or switch to the paint tool to draw it directly. Use the eraser tool to remove points instead. You can disable and enable any automation by clicking on the light blue button on the left. Now let's see how to make MIDI compositions. Create a new instrument track and drag any MIDI file you have. Or double-click within the track to make an empty MIDI event. At this point, you have to add any instrument to the MIDI track so that your notes get sound, becoming melodies or percussions either through virtual synthesizers or synths, or by playing recorded instrument samples. Let's simply drag and drop any synth from the instrument section of the browse panel. The synth is added to the whole song and selected as input source for current MIDI track. Adjust the synth properties from the piano icon. And open the Edit panel to start dropping notes with Studio One. You can eventually add notes with an external keyboard, but we won't see this in this beginner tutorial. This Edit panel shows the piano view for melodies, the drum view for percussions, and the score view. With the paint tool above, click and drag to drop any note with the correct length, and click once to remove these. Switch to the arrow tool to move notes. Adjust their length, and set their properties at the bottom, including velocity and pitch. When working with compositions, it is useful to put its region in loop. Just click and drag above any timeline to fix the loop region, and enable loop active at the bottom. The playback will be repeated on such region as long as the playhead falls within it. At the bottom, you can adjust the time signature, or beats per bar, under timing, and the tempo in BPM, which sets the conversion between beats and seconds. So the speed rate of non-rendered MIDI files. If you increase the tempo, you increase speed on all MIDI compositions. But not on rendered audio samples. You can edit MIDI events and manage MIDI tracks as we have seen for samples. In particular, you can drag a MIDI event into an audio track to render it. This is a permanent action that can't be undone. Open the Mix panel to manage your tracks in detail. This shows all your tracks, or channels, on the left, and the main track on the right, representing the song master volume. You can also open the inspector panel to get all these options for the single track instead. From the left, you can hide and show several options, but let's see the main ones you need to know. Each channel gets its volume meter in decibel, or dB, with a vertical bar to adjust volume, and a horizontal bar to set panning. You get the mute, solo, and record buttons, and the input and output sources above. For example, the MIDI channel shows its synth as input, and the main channel as output. From the effects section of the browse panel, you get the complete list of audio effects including VST, VST3, and AU external plugins. Just drag and drop any effect to apply it on an audio or a MIDI track. This gets listed inside the insert section, where you can use the I/O button to disable and enable the effect. Right-click on it to edit its properties, or remove it, and click and drag to change its order. To save your song project, use Control or Command and S. From Studio One, Options, you can go to Locations to enable autosave by defining the time range. To render your song into an audio file, go to Song, Export Mixdown. Set file name, where to save it, and the file format to use, so its options such as bit resolution and sample rate. On Export Range on the right, select what to export, for example, the current loop region, or the entire song. This is everything you can do with Studio One. Make sure to check our YouTube channel and our website to get more and free tips, tutorials, giveaways, and much more.